أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Ibn Mas'ud is telling us the story of a man from Mecca who wanted to marry a woman from Medina. So this happened at the time of the migrations where the Muslims were leaving Mecca and going to Medina. And he was a smart guy, and he wanted to hit two birds with one stone, make the migration to Medina and win the reward of being a muhajir. And the second bird is to get married to his sweetheart, and her name was Ummu Qais. So he's known by the name Muhajir ibn Muhajir Ummu Qais. There's two narrations. One of them that, as I said, wanted to go there and marry her, and he jumped on the wagon and went with the caravans to Medina. So he's been a Muhajir. Then he met his sweetheart. The other one that his future wife wanted him to make hijrah, so he would win this honor to be a muhajir. So a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam covered this subject. Also, the scholars are divided if this happened specifically because of this incident or it was before and above and beyond. And this hadith, considered by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah to be one third of Islam. So he's considering there are three hadiths cover all ahkam al-Islam, or the principle or the sharia. The first one is this one, which I'm going to tell you about. The second one, من عمل عملا ليس عليه أمرنا فهو رد. This is for innovation, adding, omitting of the deen. The third one, الحلال بين والحرام بين. So this hadith, إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته لدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. Narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. So the translation, on the authority of the Prince of the Faithful, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu an, said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, the blessing and peace be upon him, saying, actions are but by intention, and every man shall have but that which he intended. Thus, he whose migration was for Allah and His Messenger, his migration was for Allah and His Messenger. And he whose migration was to achieve some worldly benefit or to take some woman in marriage, his migration was for that for which he migrated. Narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, rahimahumullah. So this is very important in Islam, the intention and niyyah. In all aspects of ibadat, always it starts with the niyyah. It's in the heart. Some say we have to utter it in the tongue. Before salah, wudu, zakah, everything we need. As a matter of fact, when you have the intention to please God, even the common things, like going to work and so on, becomes a kind of ta'at or ibadat, or we don't want to innovate, but he will be rewarded, even feeding his wife and feeding his kids. So intention and sincerity are very important in Islam. And many of us fail this test. Now we should be aware and awake. Many of us say, oh, Ramadan is coming. Yeah, I need to lose 10 pounds. I thought you want to fast solely for the pleasure of Allah, fulfilling His commandment to you. Kutiba alaykum as-siyam, period. Of course, when you fast the right way, of course you will have some benefits from it, losing weight or being healthier or whatever. But this is not the intention, to lose 10 pounds. The same thing with zakah. Many of us, we give money to show off, especially in fundraising. And if they don't mention our name or put a plaque in our name and so on, we become irated. And many of us do the prayers for the sake of doing yoga or some kind of movement to make our joints lubricated and functioning well. And you name it. We have many, many ahadith about this. Like the first people who go to hellfire were a person who sacrificed his life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he did this for people to say he's courageous. And another one who memorized the Quran, teaching the Quran and everything, and he ended up to be a starter for the hellfire because he was doing this so they would say he's a qari. And the third one is the generous man who was given and given for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at the same time, he has some ego and he wants to be recognized and so on. So the ikhlas and the niyyah are very, very important. And the opposite of that is a shirk, al-khafi, where it creeps like ants. So always we have to examine ourselves, like the Sahaba al-Kiram used to do. And al-riya, showing off, and al-nifaq, hypocrisy. Those can sabotage all our good deed. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us be of those who has sincere intentions for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all aspects of our haya, our life, our ibadat. And the beautiful ayah in Surah Yusuf, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. This should be our motto. This should be our flag. This should be our intention to please Almighty God and do His commandments and be upright with God. May God bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.